मिस्टर सिबांग, चैप्टर टू, वर्क फॉर एनर्जी, आईसीएसए क्लास 10th, एमसीक्यूज। वर्क डन इज अ
सो वर्क डन इज अ स्केलर क्वांटिटी।
शाबाश। क्वेश्चन 5, वर्क डन इज पॉजिटिव है।
सो सी
सी वर्क डन इज फोर्स इनटू डिस्टेंस इनटू कॉस थीटा। एनी डाउट अबाउट दिस?
नो डाउट सर।
सो फॉर एग्जांपल, दिस इज अ बॉडी एंड यू आर अप्लाइंग फोर्स इन दिस डायरेक्शन, and the body gets displaced in this direction. This is the angle theta. And the amount of displacement distance that you have is d. So the answer would be f d cos theta. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir. But sir, is it distance or displacement?
Yeah, actually, it should be displacement. You're right. So this would be displacement. So this would be displacement. Is it okay now?
Yes, sir.
So f d cos theta. Question number 6, work done by a buoyant forces.
So work done by a buoyant force would be positive.
Okay, let's try to understand. Let us take a very simple example. This is water. And this is a sort of plastic box that you were trying to get into water. Yeah. Now, the buoyant force would be pushing it up. Any doubt about this?
No.
Now, when the force is being applied up, of course, the displacement would also, this plastic box would try to come up in the water. Are you able to understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
It's a common phenomenon. If you take a plastic, or you can take a simple example, you can take any container, or you can take a bucket. You can take a bucket and you have a Bisleri plastic bottle. Yeah. Now, if you try to push this Bisleri bottle inside, the buoyant force would try to push it up. And of course, the displacement would be up. So here, the force and the displacement both are in the same direction. So work done would be positive. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Okay. Question number 7. What would be the answer?
So power is equal to work upon time d.
Correct. The power is called the rate of doing work. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Few other things about power now, because we are discussing power. Work is joule. This is a unit. Time is second. And SI unit of power is watt. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Great. So just remember, power is equal to work upon time. And the work that you do on a system will get stored as energy. Any doubt about this?
No doubt.
So another formula can be work or energy would be equal to power into time. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Yeah. Now, why I'm sharing this with you is that there are two things that you need to understand. Two things that you need to understand. That you should understand that power is work done by time can also be equal to energy upon time. Have you understood this?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And another reason why this will become important is that electrical energy, if you remember, electrical energy would be equal to power into time. And in one of the formulas, if power is in kilowatt and time is in hour, then kilowatt hour is a unit of electrical energy. Mr. Sivang, is it making sense?
Yes, sir.
So we have discussed right now that kilowatt hour is a unit of energy. Okay, great. Question 9, what is force?
So force is...
Okay, let us try to play with this. Power is work upon time, any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Have you got a clue now?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Yeah.
So work can be written as FD.
FD, shabash.
And distance upon time can be written as velocity.
Shabash. So power would be equal to? Force into...
Power would be force into velocity.
And therefore, force would be equal to? Yes.
One upon velocity, C.
Power upon velocity. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Or as per this question, this can also be written as power into 1 upon velocity. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Interesting question. The question can also be asked as power velocity raised to power minus 1. Mr. CB, any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
See, you should be able to do these manipulations. That they might, because in class 10, they may not ask you very simple questions that what is power equal to. They might try to do some manipulation in the formula. And you should also be able to understand. Manage that. Okay, question number 10.
So gravitational potential energy is equal to mg.
Question 11.
Kinetic energy is dependent upon the... A.
Okay. The formula that we have is kinetic energy is equal to half mv square. Yeah. Now, as per this half mv square, if I consider this to be energy, so this would be equal to force into distance, force into displacement. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So as per this formula, this would be dependent upon force. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
So kinetic energy would depend upon force. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir.
Now this force, as per this formula, the formula that we have discussed just right now, would be equal to power upon velocity into displacement. Any doubt about this?
No doubt.
So displacement upon velocity is time, so this would be equal to power into time. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So kinetic energy would also be dependent upon time. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So the only thing that we can select right now is elasticity. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So the answer would be C. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
See, this is a sort of loose question. The things are not very obvious, but you know, just to make the best of the question, what we can understand is that the kinetic energy would be dependent upon force. It would be dependent upon time. This is the only factor that we can see this won't be dependent upon. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So not a very obvious question. Question number 12.
A rating of a pump. So it would be output upon input, P.
Power rating. So what is the formula of power rating?
So D, power output upon power input.
Okay. So let us take this formula, power output upon power input. This is what you are saying?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now let us take an example. So let us assume that I give 100 joule of 100 watt of power. And the power that I get is 80 watt. And then there is another pump where if I give 100 watt, then I get, let us say, 50 watt. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, here I can say that the power rating is 0.8. And here I can say that the power rating is 0.5.
Yes, sir.
Is it making sense?
Yes, it's making sense.
Yeah. So I can have a sort of factor of power rating. That power rating factor of the first pump is 0.8 and the power rating factor of the second pump is 0.5. So makes sense. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So power output upon power input. Great. Question number 13. Power rating of a rotary pump is?
So D.
Let us try to understand this. So now we are talking in terms of output upon input. So I have one pump where I give an input of, now because it is being asked in terms of work, so I'll be using joule. So 100 joule of input, 100 joule of input. Here I get 80 joule of output. Here I get 50 joule of output. So here the power rating can be expressed as 0.8 and here it can be expressed as 0.5. This is bigger than this. Of course, it is obvious that this gives a more power rating than this. Are you getting the point? So power rating, if it is expressed in terms of work output and work out input. So D is the correct answer. See, what I'm trying to tell you is that this power rating, just try to understand that basically, if you understand all things get related depending upon, I'm sorry, what is the input that you are giving and what is the output that you are getting? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So for example, let us take an example that you give 100 joule of energy and you get 120 joule of energy. Have you understood?
Yes.
See, this is not physically possible. As per physics laws, this is not possible, but just try to understand that what you are trying to see is that the rating in terms of the input and the output. Now that output and input can be in terms of power or it can be in terms of energy. Am I making sense?
Yes.
See, this becomes critical when you are, say, the same principle would be applicable when you are trying to study efficiency also. Remember, in pulleys, we discuss efficiencies. There also the same fundamental is used. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Great, sir. So question number 14, energy is?
A capacity to do work.
Okay. Again, as we had discussed, power is equal to energy upon time. So energy would be equal to power into time. So energy, one of the formula that you can use of energy is power into time. And energy is
capacity to do work.
Capacity to do work. Any doubt about this?
No doubt.
So this would be the right answer. Question number 15. Two basic forms of mechanical energy are?
Potential energy and kinetic energy.
Question number 16. Oscillating pendulum. Kinetic energy is at extremes is?
Zero.
So you just try to understand that if the pendulum is oscillating like this, yeah, what you need to understand is that at the extremes, the velocity would be zero for instantaneously, the velocity would be zero. Any doubt about this?
No doubt.
At the minimum, just remember, at the minimum, the velocity is maximum. Any doubt?
No doubt.
That is the first thing that you need to remember. The second thing that you need to remember is that at the extremes, at this point and at this point, the potential energy would be maximum. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
And at the mean position, the potential energy would be zero. Mr. CB, any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So, again, keep in mind, that at the extremes, potential energy is maximum, kinetic energy is zero. At the mean, so this, these two points are called extremes, and this is called mean. Here, the kinetic energy is a maximum, but the potential energy is zero. Mr. CB, any doubt?
No doubt.
Great. Okay. Another interesting question, question 17. In oscillating pendulum, the energy is maximum at?
So the
dash, energy is maximum. That's okay. The potential energy. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Question number 18. For a freely falling body, the potential energy at the top is?
So, C.
Is equal to the gravitational potential energy. Correct. Question number 19. During energy transformation, some form of energy is given out without being used anywhere. Such an energy is called?
D.
Dissipated form of energy. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So, question number 22. During free fall, the total energy at 3/4 the height is? Mr. CB.
So, D.
I'm sorry? D. So, 3/4 of the height. So, let us assume that this is the total height. Yeah. So, here, the total energy, if the total energy is assumed to be E, when you are at 3/4 of the height, 3/4 of the height. So, this would be the 3/4 height. So, at this position, the energy that you would have would be 3/4E. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir.
See, easy way of looking at this is the formula here is MgH. The formula here is Mg 3/4H. And Mg 3/4H can be written as 3/4 MgH. And we assume MgH to be E. So, this would be 3/4E. Any doubt, Mr. CB?
No doubt, sir.
Great. Question number 23. In washing machine, electrical energy is converted to?
D.
Yeah. Simple question. Okay. Let's move on to question number 24. In case of catapult, energy gets converted into kinetic energy. Which energy?
C.
Correct. Photovoltaic cell dash converts to dash.
B.
Light to? Photovoltaic. Light to?
Yes, light to chemical.
Okay. Next.
D.
Charging a lead accumulator, energy gets converted into chemical energy. Which energy gets converted? Electrical energy. Yes, Mr. CB. Next question. 1 joule is equal to kilowatt hour.
So 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 6.
Mr. Sivang, you'll have to take care
of -6.
Yeah, you'll have to take care of questions like these. See, try to understand 1 kilowatt hour. This question is very important because usually students will make very silly mistakes. See, 1 kilowatt hour can be written as 1000 watt into 3600 second. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So this would be 36 into 10 raised to the power 5 joule. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir.
So just remember that 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 raised to the power 6 joule. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir.
Now, usually whenever students will see these options, they will think that either this is option or this is option. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
But this questions like these are a big trap because what they are asking you is 1 joule. So 1 joule would be equal to 1 upon 3.6 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Kilowatt hour. Can you see this?
Yes, sir.
This will be equal to 10 upon 36. Can you see this?
Yes,
sir. Into 10 to the power minus 6 kilowatt hour. Now 10 upon 36, please try to understand 2, 5, the, 2, 8, 18, the, and when you divide 15 by 18, what you will get is 18 to the 36. You'll have 4, 1, 4, fine. And this will be 18, 6, the, 8, 6, the, 48, 6, 18, 7, the. So 7, 8, the, 56, and 7, 1, the, 12. Can you see this 0.27 figure?
Yes, sir.
So what do you see the final answer would be?
Answer B.
Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
See, questions like these are a big trap. Have you understood now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So usually, because due to the pressure, what people will do is, what students will do is, they'll select either this or this. But just keep in mind that 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 3.6 into 10 is what? What was it? 6 or 7?
Answer 6.
6, 3.6 into 10 is what? 6 joule. But 1 joule is equal to 10 upon 36 into 10 raised to the power minus 6. Any doubt?
Kilowatt. No doubt.
Great. Question number 33.
1000 watt is equal to megawatt. So 1 watt.
Okay. Let us try to understand this question. 1 watt. Okay. 10 raised to the power 6 watt is 1 megawatt. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Yeah. Now, if this is 1000 into 1000 watt is equal to 1 megawatt. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So 1000 watt would be equal to 10 raised to the power minus 3 megawatt. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So my answer would be D part. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So just keep in mind, questions like these are a bit tricky. You'll have some other questions like this, these also. Just keep in mind, they seem simple, but just try to look at the question properly. So 1 kilowatt would be equal to?
So 1 kilowatt would be equal to 1000.
This is simple and this is okay question. Question number 35.
So 35 is 1 kilowatt hour is dash mj, then 8 mj is equal to dash kilowatt hour.
Yeah, how should I do this?
No, sir, it would be 3.6 B.
So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 megajoule, any doubt?
No, no, sir.
So seems like this. And let us try to understand what is 8 megajoule. So 1 megajoule would be equal to 1 upon 3.6, and 8 would be equal to 8 upon 3.6, which would be equal to 80 upon 36, which would be equal to 2.22. So B would be the correct answer, any doubt?
No, no, sir.
Question number 36. So question number 37. For a given mass of body, if velocity is doubled, the kinetic energy is?
So 4 times.
The kinetic energy is half mv square. Given mass implies that the mass would remain the same. But what you will do is, this is kinetic energy 1, this is kinetic energy 2. What you are doing is you are doubling the velocity. So this will become 2v square. So this would be half m4v square. So this would be 4 times half mv square. So this is our original kinetic energy, this one.
Yes, sir.
So kinetic energy 2 is 4 times kinetic energy 1. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
So kinetic energy 2 is 4 times kinetic energy 1. Therefore, the kinetic energy becomes 4 times. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
Great. Okay. Question number 38. For a given mass and velocity, the kinetic energy remains constant if... Can you tell me the right answer?
So this would be A.
See, what we need to understand is, let us look at A. Mass is 4 times. So this will become 4 times. And velocity is half. When velocity becomes half, this will be V squared by 4. Any doubt?
No, no.
Rest of things remain the same. So this 4 and this 4 will get cancelled and we'll have 1 by 4 mv squared. This is equal to this. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So that is why A is the right answer.
Correct.
Now, let us look at this. Let us look at some other choice. So let us assume this choice. Mass and velocity both are squared. Now see what will happen. This will become 2m. This will become 2v square. Have you understood what I've done?
Yes.
So 2m into 4v square. Now if you see, you have increased the kinetic energy by a factor of 8. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So that is why A is the correct answer. If you want to look at this B also, then half mv square. If mass is halved, so this becomes m by 2. And velocity is doubled. If this becomes 2v square, then what would happen? M by 2, 4v square. Now this will get cancelled. So you will have twice of half mv square. Any doubt?
No doubt.
Your kinetic energy has become twice, but you want it to remain constant. So that is why A is the correct answer. Mr. CB, any doubt?
No doubt.
Yeah. Okay. So question 39. If a body of mass 5 kg is lifted from ground level to a height of 5 meter, then the ratio of the inertia is, it will remain the same because, see, basically inertia of a body is represented by its mass. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
Mass is a measure of inertia. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
So indirectly, what the person is trying to ask you, the examiner is trying to ask you, that what is the ratio of inertia, ratio of the masses? The mass would remain the same. So therefore, the ratio would remain 1 is to 1. Mr. CB, have you understood this or not?
No, no, sir.
Okay, next question. Question number 40.
So the boy uses total reach as 36 floors. So false. Let's see.
Bye.
So displacement is same, but the work is done more by the.
See, one of the very simple thing that you can understand is that if this is the 26th floor, this is the 26th floor. Yeah. The work done by the boy would be equal to the weight of boy into height of 26 floors. Let us assume that the height to be h. So this would be the work done by the boy in climbing these stairs. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
The work done by the girl would be weight of girl into the height. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
No, we are not aware of the weight of the boy or the weight of the girl. That whether the girl is heavy or the boy is heavy, we are not aware of that. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So we are not in a position to understand what is the work done by both of them. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So that is why we can't say. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Great. Question number 41.
What is the amount of force required to be applied on a body so as to, so this will be 8,000 upon 200, which will be 400 newtons, sorry.
Okay. So work is equal to force into distance. Simple question. We have 8,000 joules. We require force. And the distance is 20. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So this will be 400 newton. Just take care that you select the right option. This has newton, this has joule. Any doubt?
No doubt.
So the right option would be 8,000 by 20. 400 newton. Okay. Question number 42.
So 42 is calculate the height from which a crane can lift a load of 4 ton when a motor of 1,000 watts is operating on 20 seconds.
Yes, Mr. CB, how to do 42?
So the 42nd question, we have the power given to us and we have the time given to us. So power is equal to work upon time. By that formula, we can get the value of work.
Power is equal to work done upon time taken? Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Now, what we need to see is that what is the work done by this motor? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
The power of this motor is 1,000 watt. We need to understand what is the work that this motor is doing in 20 seconds. Have you understood?
Yes,
sir. So the work it done in 20 seconds would be equal to 20,000 joule. Have you understood this or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then this 20,000 joule, what will this do?
MGH is equal to
this. Will be equal to this, the height. It will raise the crane. It will raise the load. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So 4 ton, 1 ton is 1,000 kgs. So it is 4,000 kg into, I'm assuming g to be 10. And this would be the height. Have you understood the logic?
Yes, sir.
So now I have 1, 2, 3, 4. And I have 1, 2, 3, 4. And the h that I have is 2 by 4, or this is equal to 0.5 meter. Mr. CB, is it correct?
Yes, sir.
Great. How should I do question number 43?
So then the 43rd question, now the mass is given to us, velocity is given to us by half mv square. We can calculate the potential energy because the kinetic energy and potential energy are both extreme ends is the same.
See, roughly this is how a gun works. So in this, you have a spring like this, which is coiled. You will release this spring, and this spring will release and give energy to this. Have you understood?
Yes.
See, another way in which you can have a gun is that you can have a, you know, sort of bullet like this, and then there can be an explosion here, and then this bullet will run out. Have you understood both the working?
Yes, sir.
In one working, you have a coiled spring, and in the other, there is an explosion here. Any doubt about this?
No doubt, sir.
So let us come to this example where you have this bullet and there is a coiled spring. Now, what is being assumed is that when you, this due to some mechanical trick, if this spring gets uncoiled, then the potential energy would get transferred into kinetic energy. And what we are assuming is that all of the potential energy would get converted into kinetic energy. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So what can be assumed is that whatever is the kinetic energy of the bullet was the potential energy of the spring. Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
So this would be half into m into v square. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So this would be 4, this would be 5, and the answer would be 0.8 joule. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Great. Question 44. Are you able to do this? Question 44?
No, sir.
Okay. Let's try to understand. A body possesses kinetic energy of x joule. Yeah. If the mass of the body, so this, let this be equal to half mv square. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
If the mass of the body increases 49 times, so this is a new mass. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Determine the final velocity. You want the final velocity. I am denoting the final velocity by u. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
If kinetic energy remains constant, so therefore, whatever is this whole of this should be equal to this. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So this would be equal to half m v square. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
Okay. Now, This half gets cancelled. This mass gets cancelled. 49 u square would be equal to v square. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
U square would be equal to v square by 49. Any doubt? No u doubt, would be equal to v upon 7. Any doubt?
No doubt, sir.
So basically, what we want is that if the mass of the increase is determined, the final velocity. The final velocity is 1/7 of the initial velocity. Have you understood this or not?
Yes, sir.
So the answer would be C. Any doubt?
No,
see, this is a good question. You should try to do this again. So question 45. A heart of a rabbit beats 100 times in a minute when a fox chases it, during which the work performed is 1.52. Find the power of the heart. Okay. Now we know power is equal to work upon time. Any doubt regarding this?
No doubt, sir.
See, the work which is done is 1.52. and the time which we require. We want the power of the heart. Basically, what we want is that how much work it can done, it can do in one beat. Time taken for one beat. Have you understood this or not? Time taken for one beat. Have you understood this or not?
Yes, sir.
Again, let us try to understand. Here, the power of heart is per beat. That is the time taken for a beat. Time taken for a beat. How much work is being done? Have you understood?
Yes, sir.
Now, in this example, the work which is done is 1.5 joule. 100 beats are done in 60 seconds. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
So, one beat will take 60 upon 100 seconds. Any doubt?
Yes, sir.
And this is the time that we want, time taken for a beat. So, this will be 60 upon 100 seconds. Any doubt?
No, no, sir.
So, this will be 1.5 upon 60 into 100. This will be 15 upon 1500 upon 1500 upon 600. Any doubt? So this would be 2.5. And what is we are looking for? We are looking for the power. So this would be 2.5 watt. Any doubt? So the answer would be 2.5 watt. Any doubt?
No.
So this would be 2.5 watt. Okay. Question 46. How should I do this?
The body possesses a linear momentum of 20 kg meter per second and a mass of 2 kg. Calculate kinetic energy of the body. So first, P is equal to MV, momentum is equal to mass into velocity, and with this formula we can calculate the velocity. And then in kinetic energy formula, half MV square, we can substitute the value of the velocity and mass and find the K.
Yeah. So half into mass. Mass is 2. V is 100. V square is 100. Basically, we require V square. So V square would be 100. So the answer would be 100 joule. Any doubt?
No, no.
Question 47.
No, no. So 47, the spring is compressed by a ping pong ball of mass 100 grams. Once it's released, it flies with a velocity of 20 meters per second, find elastic potential energy.
Again, like we have discussed before, half mv square. V square. So this would be any doubt? Question number 49. Construction worker holds a heavy toolbox. How much work is done by the worker? Mr. CP.
Constructor worker holds a heavy toolbox. How much work is done by the worker? So zero, CP.
Zero. There is no displacement. So, work done is zero. Last question. Figure shows a girl pulling 5 balloons in her hand for 12 meters with a force of 1 Newton at an angle of 60 degrees below horizontal. How much work does the girl do on the balloon? How should we find this?
70 cos theta.
Why have we cos theta?
It shows, and the question is if we have to calculate the force. So we have to given the displacement and force and the angle. So
she's pulling 5 balloons in her hand for 12 meters with a force of 1 Newton at an angle of 60 degrees below horizontal. Yeah. So as per FD cos theta, the force applied is how much? 1 Newton.
Yes, sir.
The displacement is how much?
12 meters.
And what is the cos theta? What is the angle?
So cos 60 degree. 1 upon 2.
So cos 60 degree would be how much?
1 upon 2.
So the answer would be how much?
B.
I'm sorry.
So B, 6 joule.
B, 6 joule. Any doubt? Mr. CB, any doubt?
No doubt.